Hello, welcome. It's been over a year since the release of Sonic Frontiers, and as of now, the alternative version for PC hasn't been made available online. The suggestion from AgeMug2729 inspired me to conduct tests and share the results with you. Before we begin, don't forget to hit the like button to help the video reach more viewers. And if you're new here, be sure to subscribe to the channel to stay updated with all the latest news.
This video is offered by the members and Patreons of the channel.
Let's start with the good news. The game has decent visual quality on the Switch. By increasing the native resolution and applying an anti-aliasing filter, it's possible to achieve a pleasant visual, maintaining decent performance without requiring top-notch hardware. The game is fixed at 30 FPS, but for those interested, I'll leave links to mods that unlock the game to 60 FPS, both for version 1.2 and 1.3. However, I couldn't find the mod for the current version, 1.4. Speaking about each emulator separately, Yuzu currently faces several issues running the game. It's still not possible to run the game with the Vulkan API, resulting in crashes. The CPU settings need to be adjusted to accurate to avoid crashes. Therefore, users with AMD GPUs might encounter several issues if Yuzu is the only available option. During over half an hour of gameplay while recording this video, the application didn't present any significant visual issues. On Ryujinx, the performance is quite satisfactory. Even when using 4K resolution and MSA on maximum settings, maintaining 30 FPS, we conducted tests for over an hour. There were crashes while compiling shaders for new areas, but upon restarting the application, the game could be resumed from the breakpoint without losing progress. Making a comparison between the two applications might be considered somewhat unfair, as one uses OpenGL and the other Vulkan. As we know, Vulkan often showcases superior performance, even in comparison to DirectX. However, let's move forward and observe the results. Yuzu doesn't disappoint, even when using OpenGL. In the first test, using the native resolution in a not too wide area, the results are practically equivalent. It's important to note that at the time of recording this video, shaders in both applications were already compiled, eliminating the possibility of delays on Yuzu's end when compiling new shaders. In a subsequent test in a wider area, we can clearly see how the utilized API makes a difference. In Yuzu, the frame rate significantly drops to a minimum of 15, while in Ryujinx, the minimum FPS is nearly twice compared to Yuzu. Additionally, another standout point is the VRAM consumption. In Ryujinx, it doesn't exceed 2 GB, while in Yuzu, it easily surpasses 4 GB. Focusing on a more PC-like experience, I conducted tests using the mod that enables 60 FPS. As mentioned earlier, the 60 FPS mods are available only for versions 1.2 and 1.3 of the game. However, for the current version, 1.4, a mod allowing the game to run at a higher frame rate hasn't been developed yet. These tests were conducted with native resolution, without any anti-aliasing filter, and at various points, the difference in FPS between the applications was over 20 on Ryujinx. For those expecting a similar experience to native PC ports, it's important to note that a high-performance PC might be necessary to consistently maintain this game at 60 FPS. Check out the test results now. Lastly, let's perform the game test running at 4K with the 60 FPS mod. Even knowing that we can't maintain 60 FPS all the time with this CPU, we once again see a noticeable gain by using Vulkan and Ryujinx. In certain instances, Ryujinx showcases double the frames compared to Yuzu. The results of this test can be viewed now. Furthermore, something interesting that has already occurred in other games is that in some cases, like Sonic Frontiers, Ryujinx might have superior performance using a higher resolution. This trend has been observed in Zelda Tears of the Kingdom, Xenoblade Chronicles 3, Super Mario Bros. Wonder, and now, here, in the Sonic game. To conclude our video, if your PC has the capability to run Ryujinx, it's undoubtedly the best option. In the comments, I'll provide screenshots of all settings used during these tests, along with the mods to achieve 60 FPS and a second mod to improve vegetation, if preferred. It's important to note that the native PC version is still the best option, allowing FPS unlocking and offering better visual quality. Regarding Android, I haven't been able to run the game on my device. But as soon as there's an update, I'll bring a new video for you. I hope you enjoyed the content, and until next time.